Hi gang. You know, I get so many requests from you guys who are sitting down at home and you can't jump around like I normally do or like Miss Palmer normally do. And so I've decided to just put together a selection of 12-minute videos with lots of different exercises that you can do. And I'm particularly focusing on people who maybe have really stiff shoulders, who have real problems in terms of movement, of lower body, but they've got movement on the upper body, all right? So it's just some little functional fitness that you can put in place. And at all times, we're gonna do it nice and slow, so that way you can see exactly how to do it. And at any time, if you feel that something's causing you discomfort, stop, and then come back in again when you feel okay. There's some people who have MS. If you have MS, we know that fatigue is a real problem. So if fatigue is a problem for you, again, take time out. Have a rest if you need to. All right, so I'm gonna make the assumption, right, that in fact, everybody right now have a stiff shoulder, right, have difficulty in movement. And it's amazing what you can do whilst sitting at the table. And all I have here is a tea towel. And what I want you to do is you first of all, focus on sitting upright. So, you squeeze your shoulder blades together, and the thing to visualize is always that there's an orange or a lemon in between your shoulder blades, like so. Okay? And just squeeze that and hold it nice and easy. Okay, good. Release that. Here we go, let's try it again. Squeeze it. You notice how it changes your posture? You notice how automatically you want to sit up straight? Because sometimes when you're sitting down for long periods of time, this happens. Or we're walking, this happens. So we want to change that always, okay? Squeeze it together. So it's exercise for everybody, right? For everybody. Even though we're particularly focusing on people who maybe just have restricted movements, all right? From that position, what I want you to do is, we're now going to go forward, but what I want you to do first of all is to visualize that someone's really hitting you hard in your stomach. And if that was happening, you'd grab it tight, wouldn't you? So bring it in tight, okay? So we've changed the posture. Now, we're gonna go forward a bit, and I want you to go back forward as far as you can. And I'm gonna show you first, and Miss Palmer's gonna do it. You only go to the point of comfort, so you slide forward, okay? And keep looking into the corner of the room, and then come back. So let's try it again, let's have a look at this, all right? So you slide forward, and then you come forward as far as you can, as far as comfortable, and hold it there for a few moments, and then you slide back. Stomach muscles contracted at the same time as you do this. Let's try it again a couple more times. So you really push forward, and you'll find, after you've done the first one, and you're comfortable, and you understand what your body is capable of doing, you may want to go further next time. So, if that was the mark, let's try and improve on that mark. Let's come right forward this time. Come right forward, coming forward, looking into the corner of the room. Coming forward, hold it there. Contract your stomach muscles and pull back. Working the abs, working the shoulders, just warming them up. And also, it's showing that no matter how restricted you are in terms of movement up here, you can still work your abs, you can open up the shoulders. So let's try it again, one more time. Here we go, coming forward. Squeezing right forward. We're gonna hold it there. Right, now here's a little trick. We're gonna reach forward a little bit further this time. Oh my goodness. And gently we'll pull back. Good. Right, that's something you should do as often as you can throughout the day. Now, the action of cleaning, of rotating the shoulders, and that is really good for you, all right? Again, you always just sit up, and you start with one hand at a time. Okay, Miss Palmer, there you go. Right, so you start with small circles, and then you increase it as you go along. And each time you're adding more range of motion into your shoulders, so if you've got a stiff shoulder, right, this is what you do. And again, because you're having to contract your stomach muscles, you don't relax that, you're working your stomach muscles at the same time. Okay, that's one direction. Now we've got to go to the other side. Let's try the other one. Same thing. So you start small, and then as you get into it, you go wider and big circles. That's good. real good. Now, after you've done that, you want to develop. Shoulders are nice and warmed up, right? So you can use both hands now. So make sure your soles of the feet, if you're using your legs, are firmly on the floor. Otherwise, stomach muscles are tight. Relax the shoulders down. So here we go. So let's do a big circle in one direction and then the other way. And then round and then the other way. Okay, let's try that, please. So you go circle and then the other way. Go as far as you can, right to the edge of the table and then back in and then right round. That's good. Okay, great. Now, we get even more technical with this. Using one hand, we're going to go through the letters of the alphabet. And today we're just going to go to H. All right? So what you're going to do is we got the first letter is an A. So you're going to reach up and then you come back down across the other side. All right? Go up, across the middle, and back down. Let's try that once more. So you go up to the apex. You can feel it working through the shoulders. I can feel it coming down across the chest, coming back up to the middle, come across and down. Let's try it on this side. Let's have a go. So you've got an A, big capital A. Coming down the other side, and then up, across, and back down. Let's try it one more time. Right to the apex. Coming down, and up to the middle, across, and down. Let's try the other hand now. It's probably a good hand now, the right hand. There we go. Big capital A. And then down. You don't have to stick to the letters of the alphabet. You may decide, look, I'm going to spell my name. That's fine. Or the day of the week. Or your favorite word, which may be smile or whatever it is. Let's put this music on again for you guys. Okay. The other thing you can do, right, you can take numbers. So let's take the one and then back. Again, contract here, the one. We're putting variety into the muscle. Then you go the two. And then reverse that two. And then the big three. And reverse that three. And four. Yeah? Okay, let's try it from here. Let's have a look and see. So you've got big one. And then you can do the two. Yes, big two. And then the three. Here we go. Big three. And then let's switch to the other side. Let's do the one, two, three on the other side. So here we go, one. And again, contract the stomach muscles, stay upright. And then we got the two. Big two. And then we got the three. And if that's real comfortable for you, I mean, it's fun and games. If it's real comfortable for you, what you can do is, you can now use both hands. So you can do the one, because you've already done the stomach work going forward, the one, coming back. Then we're gonna do the two, right? So you go top. And then reverse that. And then we've got a big three. Yes! Let's try that.
Okay. One.
There we go. And a big two.
And reverse it.
And a three. Brilliant. Really good. And again, you do it as often as you can. It's just real good for that upper body. Now that everything's nice and warm, what we do is we reach up. That's good, and coming down, okay? If that's comfortable for you, fine. If you can only do one hand, just reach up with one hand. And then come back down. And then the other hand. And then come back down. And I like functional exercise because you can visualize the things that you do in the course of your day. So for example, you're gonna have a cup of tea or a drink. Let's do that action because we wanna work the front of the arms. So you're coming up and down, let's go, up and down. So that works the front of the arms. That's your biceps. But for the muscles to really improve and get stronger, you've got to load it up. You've got to put some weights in there. And that may mean just using, I'm using a can of, you recognize those, all right? Here we go. And you do the same action. And the more you vary the action, right? So for example, you can turn it round and do the same thing. You can change the tempo so you can come up, up, down, down. And notice resting the elbows on the table is a good way to do it. Up, up, down, down. And you can then increase that weight as much as you like. You can go onto a bottle of water, which may be heavier, or get some bags of sugar and do the same thing. You must always do both sides. So as long as you've got movement in both sides to do it, so we do a hammer curl, which is like drinking a cup of tea or drinking that bottle of beer. Okay, that's working the front of the arms. Okay, and then you can turn it round and you do the same thing coming up. That's real good. Alright, it's really good. And then you can change the tempo. So you're coming up, up, down, down. Coming up, up, down, down. If that's really easy for you, well then now you go to both of them together. So we start with a hammer curl. And don't forget, all times you can do it without. So you're coming up. And as you come up, really squeeze your elbows into the sides. So you work those biceps up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Up now, return the palms up. Up, so here we go. Coming up, again, it's the same bicep muscle we're working, but by changing the action, we work different parts of those muscle fibers. Coming up, and down, and up. Okay, good. And then this time, you're gonna come up a bit, and down a bit. Here we go, coming up, up, and down. Okay, good, put those down. Thank you, Miss Palmer. You're doing well, so put your hands here. Coming up and down. And if you only got movement on one side, that's okay. So that's it for today, gang. Really enjoy yourself. Look after yourself. It's been really great seeing you. Thank you, Miss Palmer. And look out for more of these videos. Say yeah.